Hey Mustangs. I'm Nora Van Sweden.
And I'm Vasco Hiro of your weekly broadcast for the week of May 8th.
It's almost exactly 1 month until the school year is over and AP and IB exams are in full swing.
As the seniors IB students start to finish their diploma, every year the school takes the time to recognize the teacher's hard work.
Let's hand it off to Leah to get an insight on what the IB recognition ceremony is all about and hear from seniors and their experience with the IB diploma.
Hey Mustangs, Leah here with your school news for this week. Yesterday, on May 7th, the IB recognition ceremony took place in the auditorium. The recognition ceremony takes place every year to celebrate all the IB diploma students and their hard work, and to let them say thanks to all the educators that have helped them. Let's go ask some seniors why they chose to do the full IB diploma and how it's gone for them.
I chose to do the IB diploma because so I could have a greater chance of getting into the college I want to go to, the University of Reykjavik.
I chose to do the IB diploma because I wanted to have a challenge for myself in high school and make it so I could get the college I wanted to be at, same as Kari.
I chose the IB diploma to give myself a challenge in high school. It prepares students for college and the coursework that they're going to be getting. It also gives you a lot of college credit, and it forms a group of individuals to help and support each other throughout the year.
It's gone pretty smoothly. I feel like a lot of kids make the IB diploma seem harder than it is when it's light work if you got the right mindset.
I think the same for me. It has gone very smoothly, and with the IB diploma, I got closer with a lot of my friends, as even though we were always studying, it was not that bad. We got to meet new people, and it was a fun experience.
The IB diploma, so far, it's been a little bit stressful, but going through online courses helped along, and then also having the support group of the individuals and classmates helps as well.
Thanks for the info. If you have any questions about the IB program, email Mr. Frank at jfrank@portagepsc.org. That's all from me this week. Now back to Nora and Vasco in the studio.
Thanks, Leanne. And congratulations to all of our seniors IB diplomas candidates. Nora, why are you watching?
I'm watching James Corden carpool karaoke. I'm so sad that he's leaving the Late Late Show. I loved his carpool karaoke's.
Well, I think you're in luck.
Why is that?
Because Sloane is hosting her own carpool karaoke in her car.
Let's hand it over to Sloane to hear.
Hey Mustang, Sloane here with your comedy segment for this week. With James Corden ending his run on the Late Late Show, he's going to need someone to take over carpool karaoke. So today, I'm going to go around, pick up some friends, and prove that we should be the ones to take over the segment. Wow, that was fun. That's all for me this week. Back to Nora and Vasco in the studio.
Thanks, Sloane. It looks like you might just be the next James Corden.
I would sure love to see that.
Our spring athletes are in the thick of their seasons, and regionals are quickly approaching.
So let's take a closer look to our boys' lacrosse team and see what are they doing this year.
But first, Karsten with our weekly athletics overview.
Hey Mustangs, Karsten Cooper here with this week's Sports Rundown. The week kicks off with the girls' varsity water polo team taking on Zeeland away on Tuesday. Swinging over to Wednesday when the boys' varsity golf team has a smack conference meet at Bedford Valley Golf Club. On Thursday, your varsity girls' softball team and boys' varsity baseball team both travel to St. Joe. Kicking off Friday, your girls' varsity soccer team takes on Lakeshore at Mustang Field. And on Saturday, both boys and girls varsity lacrosse teams are away, with the boys facing East Kentwood and the girls taking on Midland. And to wrap Saturday up, the boys and girls varsity track team has the SMAC championship at home. For times, details, and even more games, visit pcmustangsports.com. Now on to Josh for more info about the PC lacrosse teams.
Hey Mustangs, Josh Franz here with your athletics segment for the week. Both our boys and girls lacrosse teams played in the annual Matt Thrasher game last weekend at Forest Northern. The games are played in memorial of Matt Thrasher, who died in a tragic boating accident in 2004, and was a goalie for Porsche's combined teams wearing number 88. Let's hear from some of our Mustangs on what this game means to them.
I love Matt Thrasher because I get to see a bunch of like people play and learn from them, and I just also love the memorial from him because he died in a tragic accident, and it's nice to also put that out there.
I think it's really good that both Portage Central and Portage Northern can, you know, get together and just support a good cause and like support the Thrasher family.
I'm excited for the Matt Thrasher game because it's a fun rivalry, and I get to hang out with my friends.
That's all for me this week. Go and support our lacrosse teams as their seasons conclude. Back to the studio.
Thanks, Josh and Karsten.
Hey, Bosco.
What's up?
Did you know that the last band concert of the year is coming up?
No, I didn't. I can't believe it's already the last one.
I know. Let's hand it off to Hamid with more information about the last band concert of the year.
Hey, Mustangs. Hamid here for your activity segment this week. The Port Central Bands had their spring concert last week featuring student-composed music by Cameron Nelson. It also served as the last concert for longtime band director Mrs. Flynn, who has been a beloved member of our school community for many years, and her dedication to the band program has left a lasting impact on countless students. In her time as director, the Port Central Bands have consistently earned top honors in competitions and performances. Thank you, Mrs. Flynn, and we hope you have a wonderful journey into retirement. Now back to Nora and Vasco in the studio.
Thanks, Hamid. Bosco, we're filming. You have to put your phone away.
Oh, sorry. I was just chatting with my Snapchat AI.
The Snapchat AI is so scary.
I think it's pretty interesting, though. Let's see what other students here at PC think about our Snapchat AI.
Hey, Mustangs. Elise here with your pop culture segment for the week. As we all know, AI has taken over the world. Artificial intelligence, or AI, has become an increasingly important part of our lives. From virtual assistants like Siri and Alexa to self-driving cars and advanced medical technologies, AI is changing the way we live and work. While AI has many potential benefits, there are also many concerns about its impact on society. Some worry AI could lead to job loss and economic inequality, as machines replace human workers in certain industries. Now that artificial intelligence is continuing to evolve and become more integrated into our lives and has now entered Snapchat with each user getting their own personal AI, let's hear a little from our Mustangs on what they have to say.
So I feel like AI is definitely gonna be like something that could like cause a problem but also be like really helpful because it can help like further things that we like didn't really know about, but like also it might take over like with the school system on how people can just easily like ask it to give it summaries for books and everything, so it could like harm school systems that way.
My thoughts on AI, I think it's like gonna be like the new internet. It's gonna be like, it's gonna be really revolutionary and like be a big thing, and like it's already kind of a big thing, like schools are already adjusting and adapting to it, so I definitely think in like the next 10 years it's gonna be a pretty big thing. I mean it already is.
So I did end up changing my Bitmoji's name and what it looks like. I named it Therapist because I'll just ask it like a bunch of random questions, and just like if I have like random advice I like need help with, then I'll just ask it.
I changed my Snapchat Bitmoji's name to Larry. I just thought it was a goofy name, and I thought like to myself, like if I ever needed to ask something, I could just say, let me ask Larry. And I thought that was kind of funny. That's it, really.
Those sure are some interesting takes. That's it for me this week. Back to Nora and Vasco in the studio.
I'm Nora.
And I'm Vasco.